Right. This video is going to go over least common multiple, often written LCM. And first, let's just talk about what that means. We're going to end up finding the least common multiple of a list of numbers, two numbers, three numbers, etc. And I will do videos on the different types of methods. But first, let's just talk about what it means. So let's say you were asked to find the least common multiple of 8 and 12. Well, what this means is if you were listing all the multiples of 8 and you were listing all the multiples of 12, which is the smallest number that's a multiple of each of them? So you could list the multiples of 8. By the way, I don't suggest using this method, but this is so you can understand what it means by least common multiple. So first of all, we're going to list the multiples of 8. Well, 8 times 1, 8 times 2, 8 times 3. Basically, you just keep adding 8 and you'll get all the multiples of 8. And this list would go on forever and ever and ever. There is no end to the list of multiples of 8. And then we're going to list the multiples of 12, starting off with 12 times 1, 12 times 2, 12 times 3, etc. And this list also goes on and on forever and ever. So there are some common multiples. What are the common ones? For 8 and 12? Well, I can see they both have 24 in common, and that's the smallest one I see. Now, there are more. For instance, if I would have gone to the next number here, a couple of the next numbers, 32 and 8 is 40, and then 48, you're going to get some more multiples. But again, there's going to be no end to this list, but really what matters is the very smallest one. We want the smallest or the least common multiple would be 24. Well, that's a lot of work to have to list all the multiples and then kind of visually go through the list and find it. But that's really what it means if you want to understand what the words are, least common multiple. You could shorten this process just a little bit. What if you said find the least common multiple of 4, 6, and 10? What you could do is just take the biggest number and list its multiples. So the multiples of 10, you've got 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, and of course this keeps going on. And what you do is you list the first one, you see if it's a multiple of either of these other two numbers. Well, 4 doesn't go into 10. 4 goes into 20, but 6 doesn't go into 20, so that's not a multiple of both of them. 30. 4 doesn't go into 30, but 6 does, so that's not a multiple of both of them. And as you go through the list, 40 is not a multiple of either of both 4 and 6. 50 is not a multiple of both of them. 60 actually is a multiple of both 4 and 6. So that's another way to find it. If you don't want to list all those multiples, just ask yourself, does both 4 and 6 go into each of these multiples of 10 until you find it? And so again, the answer here is going to be 60. But again, like I say, this is kind of a lengthy process having to list all the multiples. But that's what it means. When you're trying to find the least common multiple, what you're really being asked for is what is the smallest number they both go into without, they all go into without a remainder. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you the most common way taught in books for getting the least common multiple, and then I'm going to suggest, after looking at it, that you look at my other videos, which I think show some easier ways to do it. All right, here's another way of doing it by using prime factorization. So we're going to take the same problem, find the least common multiple of 4, 6, and 10. All right, so what we're going to do is list the prime factorization for these. So 4 is 2 times 2, and 6 is 2 times 3, and 10 is 2 times 5. Now, if we write that using exponents, 2 squared for 4, 2 times 3, there's no exponents in that. We're saying we want to be a multiple of each of those numbers. So I have to have at least the prime factors in each of the numbers. So I would say the least common multiple, I'm going to have look at all the different kinds of prime factors. There's a 2, a 3, and a 5. So you write down there, you know you've got to have at least a 2, and you need to have at least a 3, and then a 5. And then you look and see how many factors of each of those do you need for any one of these numbers, 4, 6, or 10. Well, in 4, you need 2 squared. You need 2 factors of 2. So you need a 2 squared. Well, for 3, you only need 3 to the first power and 5. So this is also a way to get the least common multiple. Is you do it by circling the prime factor that has the highest exponent on it. The highest exponent here, there's only one of them. And you multiply those together. And so you can get the least common multiple this way. And now you just multiply that out. You have 4 times 3 times 5. The way I do this is I know 4 times 5 is 20. And 20 times 3 is 60. So notice I get the same answer. It's just a different approach than listing all the multiples of 10 or all the multiples of 4, 6, and 10. All right, let's do another problem like this. All right, let's use this method to find the least common multiple of 12 and 20. So if I prime factor 12, remember you could just use a factor tree if you can't do it in your head. It's going to be 2 squared times 3, and for 20, I have 4 times 5, which is 2 squared times 5. So for 12, I've got 2 squared times 3, and 20, I have 2 squared times 5. So I look at the different kinds of prime factors, so the least common multiple is going to be, have to have at least these types of factors. Right now I need to get the right exponent. I do, for factor of 2, take the highest exponent I see, and that's 2 squared, so that'll give me 2 squared. And for 3, there's only one place you have a 3 again, so I'm just going to have a 3 to the first power. And for 5, there's only one factor, so this will be my answer. And lo and behold, this just happens to be 60 again, but that's just a fluke. Let's try another one. All right, how about finding the least common multiple of 12, 45, and 35? See if you could try this by prime factoring each of these using any method and then multiplying the appropriate factors together. All right, for 12, if you prime factor, you would get 2 squared times 3, because that's 4 times 3. 45 is 5 times 9, so, and 9 is 3 squared. Notice how I'm going to write this. 3 squared, 9 times 5. I'm kind of writing the 3, the same factor underneath it. You don't have to do that, but sometimes it's kind of cool if you do it this way. And for 35, it's 5 times 7, so I'm going to write that the 5 times the 7. It's easier to see the highest factor this way. You can see there's 4 different kinds of factors. So the least common multiple, for the 2's, you're going to do with the highest degree. For the 3, with the highest degree. And for the 5, these are the same, right? Either that 5 or this 5. And there's going to be a 7. So you're going to end up with, first of all, you could have just written 2, 3, and 5, and 7. Those are the different factors, but you need to do the ones with the highest degree. So 2 squared and 3 squared. And then you can get out a calculator and multiply this to see what you get. All right. I think that's 1,260. But notice it's a very large number, and you can see why this method's a lot easier than actually listing all the multiples of 12, 45, and 35. Of course, not all of them, but until you see one that's exactly a multiple of all of them. And if you did list enough numbers, you would get to 1260. But that obviously is just too much work. All right, I want you to go on to my other videos, which I think are even easier ways to get the least common multiple.